Afternoon. Welcome to daily currency update from the currency desk. Yesterday, we saw some sideways movement for the US dollar against the Indian rupee. Earlier in the morning session yesterday, the Indian rupee rose up to 3.5 month high, and later on we saw some of those gains being covered. Though at the end of the day, the Indian rupee ended with some gains, but most of the gains from the earlier part of the day were covered. Throughout the day yesterday, we had some indicative statements given by the Indian government. The Indian government has made the decision to cut some defense and welfare expenditure. This is expected to contribute significantly to the fact that the fiscal deficit is reducing. Now, one of the major threats for the economy is obviously the increase in the fiscal deficit of our country, which increases the need for borrowing. Since government is taking such steps, it is supposed to help reduce the fiscal deficit and in turn support the economy. Again, another move taken by the government yesterday was the IPO of OIL India Limited, OIL Limited, and government has sold around 10% stake in the company, which is again expected to support the budget of the government. Through these measures, government has sent in a positive signal to all the rating agencies, and overall this is expected to help stabilize India's debt rating outlook in the longer run. Again today, we had a weak opening for the Indian rupee in the morning session. This is mainly being attributed to the fact that we had a lower than expected Chinese manufacturing PMI data. This disappointed the markets not only in India but also the equity markets all across Asia in the morning session. And tracking those losses, again in the US dollar we had some gains. Today we had the PMI data which was released for the month of December, which came in much lower than expected. Again, not much can be read into it because we are expecting an improvement to be seen in the current quarter. Obviously the GDP forecast has been cut to a certain extent, and all the reduction in output has been factored in, but we didn't see much impact of the lower than expected PMI India data. Again, dollar is holding strong up to the level of 53.50. We could expect some selling. We are seeing some selling around 53.50 levels. So until the time 53.50 is broken, one can take a sell position in the USD INR with a stop loss of 53.50 in the spot. Coming to the Euro posted a gain for the 6th straight month. This is one of the strongest rally for the Euro against the US dollar and all the global currencies since about a decade. This rally yesterday was mainly fueled by the fact that we had a statement from the Federal Reserve stating that it would continue its quantitative easing stimulus until the time the jobs data does not improve or the jobs situation does not improve. We had a lower than expected jobs data as the unemployment claims rose in the US market. So based on this, markets are expecting the QE to continue, and the Euro found some support by this news. Also supporting the US, the Euro, was the fact that we had bill being passed by the Fed, by the US Senate, which approved the suspension of the debt ceiling limit for the period of 3 months until a valid bill is or a regulation has been passed out by the US houses. Based on the bill, both the chambers of the Congress have to pass the budget resolution by April 13th, which is a deadline for them. Based on this statement, we had some weakness in the US dollar against all the major currencies across the globe. Especially the US dollar index fell by more than 100 basis points from 80.64 levels seen yesterday to 79.22 levels today in the morning session. Again, today we have a lot of data from the European front which could bring in some movement, but overall the trend for Euro continues to remain bullish. We are seeing Euro INR also trading at near lifetime highs of around 73. Today we can expect the rate to cross above 73 levels. The data that is due from the Eurozone today for release is the Eurozone PMI data, flash CPI data, as well as the unemployment rate. So based on these economy-based data, we could see some movement intraday. Overall, the trend for Euro remains bullish. Against the US dollar, it is expected to touch 1.37 levels. But compared to that, against the Indian rupee, we could see the Euro strengthen only if the Indian rupee does not strengthen more. Coming to the pound, we had a positive data from UK and we saw the pound rise again for the third day on the trot. Currently, the trend technically seems to be going in the bullish levels from sideways. We had the UK consumer confidence and housing price index data yesterday coming out, which were both much better than expected. Today we have the UK PMI manufacturing data, which is due in the afternoon, and based on that we could see some movement. Though overall the trend for the pound continues to remain bullish. We have seen a lot of downside in the pound in the against the Indian rupee in the recent January month, so we could see some retracement in the GBP INR rates. Coming to the Japanese yen, we saw a sharp fall in the Japanese yen against the US dollar to a nearly 2.5 year low yesterday and today in the morning session. This was based on two factors. First is there were reports that the Prime Minister Shinzo Abe is due to announce a new governor for the Bank of Japan, that is Central Bank of Japan. The main objective of this, the main rumors going along with this was the fact that the new governor would bring in lot of additional stimulus so as to ensure that the high inflation target has been met. Again, in the morning session, we had two negative data from the Japanese economy. First was the UK household spending, and another data that came out on the negative side was the unemployment data. So based on these two negative data, we recommend a strong sell in the Japanese yen against the Indian rupee. The current target can be kept at around 56 levels with a stop loss of around 59.50 in the spot. Thank you.